This screencast applies a concept learned in Chapter 3, Separators, to the chlorobenzene production plant started in Chapter 1, Introduction to Aspen Plus. To begin, open your chlorobenzene production plant simulation you saved after Chapter 2. Go to the simulation environment. Create two DISWU models in series as shown. We will utilize a DISWU model as opposed to RadFrac because we don't know the reflux or number of stages necessary to achieve the desired product specifications. Connect the crude outlet stream from the washer to the first DISWU. Because the two chlorobenzene products are less volatile than benzene, they will proceed to the second distillation column in the bottoms product from the first distillation column. The distillate product from the first column will primarily contain benzene, which can be used as a potential recycle source in the process. The distillate product in the second distillation column will contain primarily monochlorobenzene, and the bottoms product will contain primarily para-dichlorobenzene. Once the flow sheet is set up, it should look like this. Click on the green next arrow to proceed. For the first DISWU, specify the reflux ratio as 1.5 times the minimum reflux. This is a commonly used reflux ratio for distillation columns. Specify the condenser and reboiler pressures as 1 atmosphere. Specify the light and heavy keys as benzene and monochlorobenzene, with distillate recoveries of 99 and 2%, respectively. Click the green next arrow to enter information about the second DISWU. Again, specify the reflux ratio as 1.5 times the minimum reflux ratio, and the condenser and reboiler pressures as 1 atmosphere. Specify the light and heavy keys as monochlorobenzene and dichlorobenzene, with distillate recoveries of 98% and 1%, respectively. Save the file where it can be accessed later. Watch the following tutorial screencasts in Chapter 4, Heat Exchangers, to continue the series.